Hi, this is Shadi, and today I'm gonna discuss with you and try to analyze or at least try to predict who is gonna go to the Tokyo 2020 Olympics between Abe and Maruyama. So recently the list of the Japanese team came out. Kosei Inoue did a press conference where he was in tears because he knew that choosing one over the other, it means blocking his Olympic dreams, like Nagayama, Ryunsuke Haga, and so on and so forth. So the feminine list is as follows. The minus 48 is Funa Tonaki, minus 52 is Uta Abe, 57 Tsukasa Yoshida, 63 Miko Tashiro, 70 Shizuru Arai, 78 or minus 78 Shori Amada, plus 78 is Akira Sone. And the masculine is the 60 is Takato, 73 is of course Ono, 81 is Nagase, minus 90 is Soichiro Mukai, minus 100 Aaron Wolf, which honestly I would prefer Ryunsuke Haga. He is far more fluent and his Uchimata is just sublime, and his technique overall is far more represented than Aaron Wolf. And the plus 100 is Harasawa of the 2016 Rio de Janeiro Olympics. So as you can see, the 66 is still left for decision. So when it comes to Joshiro Maruyama and Hifumi Abe, it has become very interesting all the way from the beginning in 2017, where Abe beat Maruyama in Tokyo, and then in Osaka, after being crowned world champion, losing in golden score to Maruyama with that sublime Tomoe Nage, and in the All Japan last year, and in Tokyo in the semifinals, until Abe finally beat Maruyama again in the Osaka Grand Slam of 2019 in golden score. See, the rule was that if you win the world championship in Tokyo and the Osaka Grand Slam of 2019, you would go on and qualify immediately for the Olympics. So, for example, the plus 78 woman Akira Sone, she actually qualified that way. She won the world title in Tokyo and also won the Osaka Grand Slam. Joshiro lost in golden score against Abe, and this is where things became far more interesting. And now we don't know who's gonna go. The whole list is made up except the 66. So we all thought that it may have been, or it could have been, resolved in Paris, but none of them showed up. Then we thought, okay, it's gonna be resolved in Dusseldorf. Only Hifumi Abe showed up, and he was monstrous with his performance. It's like the 2017 Abe is back. And like I talked about in my judoka profile, I hope he bounces back because it's gonna make things far more interesting. And this is what is exactly happening. So now, if I had to predict or try to assume how they're gonna qualify, it's gonna be none other than the All Japan of 2020 for several reasons. First, I don't think they're gonna resolve it in the IJF World Tour because there's no Japanese Grand Slam or Grand Prix anymore. So I think they're gonna resolve it in Japan. So you see, it was either Tokyo and Osaka, which are both in Japan. So what's left is to solve it once again in the Nippon Budokan in the All Japan of 2020, because it's hometown, it's away from the IJF World Tour, and also it's home performing against their own people, in front of their own people, and they're gonna show who's gonna be the best in 66 in all of Japan. So it remains to be decided, but I predict they're gonna try to resolve it in the All Japan, and this is where they're gonna take their decision. And I'm talking about Kosei Inoue and the rest of the heads of the coaches in the Japanese team. It's not gonna be in some Grand Slam or Grand Prix, because if that was the case, they would have resolved it in Paris or Dusseldorf. Both of these are very grandiose competitions, and only Abe showed up for Dusseldorf. None of them even bothered to show to Paris, because you know, Paris is very prestigious, but again, nobody showed up, meaning It's gonna be decided in another fashion, and I predict that it's gonna be in the All Japan. They're gonna go head to head in the finals or the semifinals, and I hope it's the finals. It's gonna be another crucial golden score, and the winner is gonna be the selected for the Tokyo 2020. So, what do you think? Who's gonna be selected? Let me know down below. I predict that, well, I cannot predict, but I really don't know who's gonna qualify. Both of them really want it bad, and both of them are very talented. So, and Hifumi Abe seems to be in perfect shape. Who's gonna qualify? Let me know down below. I subjectively prefer Maruyama, but you know, this is judo. You cannot predict anything. Again, this was Shadi. And before you click off, if you enjoy this video or any of my videos, click the like button. It would really help me out. And thank you for listening.